He's played a major role in the advancement of e-business in this region, including formulating the Dubai e-government strategy itself. He's a graduate member of Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum's leadership program. He's a graduate member of the Dubai Leaders Program of Dubai World. He's a member of the steering committee of Dubai World Information Technology Center. He's an advisor to the Dubai Expo 2020. He's the chairman of the Customs and Trade Facilitation Committee. I've got a long list here of this man's many achievements, and we don't have all day to go through them, I'm afraid. So I'll cut that short and bring him onto the podium. Ladies and gentlemen, could you please give a warm welcome to the CEO of Dubai Trade, our friend, Mr. Mahmood Al Bastaki.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. By the way, I'm the only one wearing this. I looked again. This tells you something about Dubai. 20 years ago, I was telling a joke to one of my friends that there will come a time the tourists will stop us in 2070 and they'll tell us, oh, that guy, he's still wearing this. And it happened to me a couple of weeks ago. I want to start something not related to logistics, then link it to logistics. Okay? 100 years ago, an Arab poet by the name of Khalil Gibran wrote something very appealing that I keep reading and try to link it to our world. Khalil Gibran said in his book, The Prophet, in the chapter, Children, he said, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. For they have their own thoughts. You may house their bodies, but not their souls. For their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, nor tarries with yesterday. Ladies and gentlemen, these words, if you think about what Gibran said 100 years ago about children, think about your employees and the organization as your children. Those children, those employees have dreams, have thoughts that you as the head might ridicule for a certain time, might not believe on. But do not be the suffocators of ideas. Let the ideas flow. Even what we learned in the school 20 or 25 years ago, it has nothing to do with what's going on today. I was just giving a speech last week, giving the example of a social media manager post if it was circulated 30 years ago. Would anybody understand what social media manager is? Didn't exist, it doesn't make any sense. What's the social? There was no social and there was no media. Social media. So just to link what Gibran was saying, he's talking about tomorrow. Those employees, some of the employees have ideas that we as elders and leaders and supervisors or managers might not have. Let it flow. If 20 ideas come, maybe one or two will be a game changer. all these dreams that in the past, if you look at Steve Jobs, when he was saying in 1997, a lot of people were not seeing what he was saying. Okay, Steve Jobs is not like everybody else. My people, some people think, but there could be a small Steve Jobs in your organization, in the field that you are in, that he might have some innovative idea that will change your world. Our logistics world has really changed, and we've been seeing dramatic changes throughout the last 2 years. It's never happened in the industry. What I have seen, what's happening to the ocean freight is the same what happened to the IT technology 20 years ago. What happened to the IT technology 20 years ago? There were so many consolidation. Only the big guys stayed. The Microsoft, the Oracle, the HP, only these people, and they wanted to acquire everybody else. Any startup, the minute they see them coming, they acquire them. To a degree that I remember Oracle was saying in a daily basis, they had 5 to 10 acquisitions. They wanted to get everybody. Our industry of logistics and ocean freight, it's a massive change. The latest thing that I'm sure many of you would be aware of is the alliances. All the big guys are getting into alliances, coalitions, not because they like each other. It's a call for survival. Some of them, they built way beyond what the market demanded. So there was no match between the demand and supply. The overcapacity of vessels, the mega vessels, they don't know how to fill it because the cargo is not flowing. So they had to get together, which is a smart move. So this change in the industry, you as a player in the supply chain, you should think about it, how this affects you in terms of rate, in terms of the market dynamics, because it's changing a lot of things. This coalition of the 2M, the Ocean Freight, the Ocean Alliance, and the Alliance, and maybe the three Japanese getting together as an alliance, it's affecting the ports. Some ports are getting advantage because more calls. Some ports used to have 9 calls in a week, now they have 12 and 13 calls, like the ports of Singapore. Some ports were disadvantaged because of this alliances. And this affects the end user, the consumer, the business, of planning your supply chain and planning the arrival of the goods. This alliance even will affect the ports. Will they dictate new rules in the ports, new rates, because they are getting together? They are changing the routes of the trade lanes in the world. And as port operator, even the port operators now think differently. The port operator, their main customer has always been the shipping line. Today, they are thinking differently. Their main customer is the customer, the cargo owners. Because if I'm the cargo owner and I bring 100 containers a week, I will tell my shipping line, I want you to bring it here in this port. They dictate the rules now. So even the ports, they're changing their direction of focus. I'm sure in some of your business, you have to think how this is affecting you at large. The area in the Middle East is going through a massive change. We have catastrophes in Yemen, in Syria, in Iraq, part of Libya, and this creates new horizons of business for some people. The humanitarian logistics, which today is one of the topics we'll be talking about, it's becoming more vital to feed and to make these people live, the people who are in catastrophe. E-commerce, something that we'll talk today and the expert will talk about it, is changing our world. I've seen many retailers now thinking about how can I put, they never thought about this, but they have been pushed to do this. The new generation, the children that I started my speech with, are dictating you to change. The children for tomorrow, they want you, as the guru and the leaders of your company, to shift your ways to a new way, to a mobility. Everything's quick, fast. So you have to adapt as well. I've seen giant retailers putting their things on online, selling things online in different areas. As you know, souq.com emerged from Dubai, which is we are proud of, acquired by Amazon. Amazon is coming in a big scale here. And they will reshape the market trends here. Noon.com. You've heard of Noon.com? It got delayed a little bit, but their ambition is very, very, I mean, inspirational. They were talking about within the city, if you order something, was it 2 hours delivery? I mean, usually it's overnight, 2 hours, 3 hours delivery, that's never happened. This is pushing the envelope. So things are moving. In the area you've heard about NEOM. NEOM is what I relate to Gibran as well. The dreamers. This is the dreamers business place. Imagine living in a whole city across three countries, Jordan, Egypt, and Saudi Arabia, with robots, self-driving cars, renewable energy, vertical farms. It's a lifestyle change. So the ambition and the dreams using technology